दराज पर्दे करो किनारे, खूटे से बंदी है हवा मिलके छुड़ाओ सारे। आ जाओ पतंग लेके अपनी ही रंग लेके, आसमां का शामियाना आज हमें है सजाना। क्यों इस कदर हैरान तू, मौसम का है मेहमान तू। ओ दुनिया सजी तेरे लिए, खुद को जरा पहचान तू।
गुड मॉर्निंग, हाउ आर यू ऑल? सो दिस इज 28th ऑफ नवंबर, द लास्ट डे ऑफ इफी। पता भी नहीं चला पूरा फेस्टिवल अब ओवर होने को आया। सो द फाइनल डे, क्लोजिंग सेरेमनी। स्पेशल अट्रैक्शन बताऊं आज तो द गोलमाल सीरीज मैन, यस, रोहित शेट्टी। सो रोहित शेट्टी आ रहे हैं आज, उनका एक मास्टर क्लास है और आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू अटेंड दैट ऑल्सो। सो उसका अपडेट दूंगा, उसके अलावा कुछ फिल्म्स भी। और सबसे ज़्यादा तो एंटरटेनिंग है आज क्लोजिंग सेरेमनी। अभी तो पता भी नहीं कि कौन कौन से गेस्ट आने वाले हैं, वो आर द चीफ गेस्ट एंड व्हाट आर द सरप्राइजेस। ऐसा सुना है कि कुछ आज भी म्यूजिकल रहेगा जैसे ओपनिंग में था। आई होप कि शायद कुछ ग्रैंड हो। उस दिन शंकर महादेवन थे ओपनिंग में, तो आज भी कुछ बहुत मस्त हो। सो मिलते हैं कुछ देर बाद कुछ और नए अपडेट्स के साथ। गुड बाय।
Is so beautiful, there's so much of variety out here, and more than anything else, the people are really chill out here. That's what I like. That's what I like. Not hazard at all. Kya karo tum log, kyun karo? They don't want to be wannabes. They're like, they're in their own world, happy, and that's what I like, because I'm somewhat that kind of person.
But Golmaal would be your first film, as you said, that you shot in Goa.
Yeah.
Golmaal was also your breakout film in a real sense.
Yeah.
Made you the superstar director as we know you since. How did that particular film happen to you?
It was not planned. Okay. Sometimes how it is said, like you should just go with the flow and trust what is there for you. The same thing happened with me. I was making a thriller with Ajay, and out of the blue Neeraj Mehta, writer of the film, God bless his soul, is Nolo. He came to me and he told me that there's a play I had done a long time ago, and I want to narrate you that play. Would you be interested to make a film of that play? I was like, Neeraj Vora was like, he's given Hera Fairy and all those things. And I was like, why not? And I heard the script, I heard the play basically. And I was like, I want to make this film. That same evening, I went to Ajay and I said, I don't want to make that thriller what we are doing. I want to make this film. And he was like, I am an action hero. You are an action director. And you want us both to come and make an action film, a comedy film. Well, let's see. My conviction is that this film will work. And that's how it started.
I can actually quiz you and you'll know the answer.
I think so. I can't proclaim that, but if I don't know the answer, I'll say I'm not well, so that's why I can escape from that.
But you know, besides the fact that you grew up watching a lot of films, as a lot of filmmakers do, and drawn to a certain kind of cinema, the blockbuster entertainment cinema, you're also someone who grew up in a film set. You were around films at a more real level. If I'm not mistaken, wrote your first film shoot that you went to was Shalimar.
Your first outdoor was Shalimar.
Tell us something about the experience of being in various film sets that you went. What did you see? What really struck you about that world? I'm sure you were drawn to it in a huge way.
It's quite strange and amazing where I come from, my journey. Like, many people ask me when you decided to become a director or an action director. And I tell them I don't know. Because I always thought that this is what I'll be doing. This is a part of me. Like going to school and then I'll be making films like my dad. I'll be an action director like my dad. So it was in the culture of my family, I would say. It was never that I will grow up and I will then decide like, what I have to do in my life.
There was no doubt in your head.
No doubt. It was no doubt, and it was not that, okay, I have to do this. I was like, I will be doing this. It goes this way for me. And so that's why I think it was never such one day like I decided to be an action director or a director for that matter. It was always, okay, what my dad is doing, I'll be doing the same thing. And it was, I think, I started when I was 16.
Right.
After schools.
Right.
I never been to college. It's been, this December I'll complete 30 years.
Right.
I'm not that old, but still I'll complete 30 years.
You're not saying.
It should not be KRA, why should I?
But as, you're speaking about money, being paid 100, making sure the service...
You're coming to my commercial aspect.
No, not. I'm actually coming to your personal life, alright. You lost your father at the age of 9. You know, he was a very well-known action director, but also a well-known actor among a lot of people at the time. You know, you have siblings, a family. Was it hard on you economically?
It was very hard. It was not easy. But when you're going through that hardship, it's very difficult. And then when you're successful, that becomes a story. That becomes the dramatic point of a story.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, we have gone through a lot. There was a time there was no money to for my mom to pay my school fees. We had to shift from, we were staying in the suburb of Mumbai, and then we had to shift some far away because of the rents, and our house was taken away, cars were taken away. So, yeah, we have gone through that hardship, but never was a day that I blamed anyone. Never was a day that I looked up and said, God, why me? Never. It never happened. That's not me. So, I don't know why. I don't have any... scientific reason or for that, or spiritual reason for that, but that's me. And it was a tough journey, but I was always happy and positive, and I think because of that I got it. And I used to love comedies, not that I used to not love comedies, but I never thought that my second film will again be a comedy. And it worked, and then we realized that this is what the artists want from us, and so let's cater that.
Because you really took that route in a big way, like even Sunday or All the Best,
yeah.
These are all comedy films, and of course, a bunch of Goldmas thereafter,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, so it's just that because it worked for me, and I thought, okay, let's, and we started, and when I was doing Goldmas 3, that time I told her, I share a very personal equation with him, like a brother. And then are you cheating the audience? They were just giving comedies. I want to make an action film with you. He said, okay, whenever you have a script, let's do it. Let's try. It should not be like, are we becoming an escapist? You know, we met Gulmar, then you met Gulmar Return, then you met all the best, then you became Gulmar 3. So is that an easy way out, or should we try an action film? I want to try an action film. So I started feeling, am I taking the easy way out for my audience? And that's how Singham happened. It was again a risk.
So how did Singham happen?
Accident.
Accident, okay.
That was a
nice accident.
Yeah. But it was a big risk also.
With you.
Yeah.
So it works the other way around, where it doesn't matter what you want to make, but Shah Rukh is there, he'll give you dates, and you have to figure out what to make.
But it's not easy. It's like, if you don't take it very seriously, if you don't take it for granted, you get sleepless nights. Like, I'm doing serious Suryavanshi, but it's more stressful than my first
film. I can see it.
Yeah. Like last night I was shooting, today I'm here. Night I go back and I shoot again from tomorrow.
Crazy.
So because I take it as a responsibility. Not that I'm not stressful that film chalegi, nahi chalegi. I take it as a responsibility because the audience have taken us here. You know, there are so many directors. There are so many filmmakers. Much, much more talented, much more better than me. But today here I stand with 12 blockbusters. So I consider myself lucky, and it is all because of the audience. So, and I know that they will be coming with an expectation that okay, they have done Singham, they have done Simba, now they are bringing Suryavanshi.
Right.
So that is the stress that I have to deliver what they are accepting from me, expecting from me, you know. That is the most important thing for me. So that is the stress. And that's always been for me, and that will always be for me. So it's easy that you get an access to actor, everybody wants to work with you. But the other part of it is that it becomes more difficult. Like, Suryavanshi is more difficult for me than Zameen, or for that matter, than Simba, or for that matter,
is getting hard and hard, are you saying?
Don't take it for granted.
Right.
And it should be.
Right.
For anyone, it should be. You should have sleepless nights because there is so much at stake. And you can't take things for granted. It's chalta hai, audience ko toh, yeh chalta hai, humne banaya chalta hai. That's never been my...
See, my dad was famous for this, and I follow that. My normal crew, my production team always makes fun of me. My normal crew, the chota crew is here is for 250 people.
Okay.
It's a mini crew, which is 220 people, 230 people. And for me, it is, you know, my dad used to do this, I also do that. Many people tell me, hey, you call that dancers, they are the sitting, or the fighters, they are the sitting. Or you call junior artists for 2 days, 3 days, or workers who are not doing well. So for me, it is like, aadhe kaam karenge, aadhe dua denge. So, you know, who knows kiske blessing is hum log ka chal raha hai. And it's not made a difference giving a unit a good food or calling some extra people who are not at work and paying them. The film never goes over budget, or film never flops because of that. It's never happened with me, so yeah, it works for me.
Is Shah Rukh Khan. Tell us the story behind Chennai Express. I hear that you were making the remake of Angoor.
Yeah.
That was the film that you were going to do with Shah Rukh.
It just happened after Golmaal 3. During Golmaal 3, Shah Rukh called me and said, we had a normal interaction that he loves my films. You know, let's do a film together types. And I said, yeah, I have a script. I have a rights of old classic Angoor. And he was very happy. It was his mother's favorite film, it seems. So he said, okay, let's do it. And then we started writing the film. So obviously, if you see Angoor, it's a very simple film.
Right.
And here comes me. I made everything larger than life. And then when we did the final drafting, me and my writer, Yunus, we sat and we said that the essence of the simplicity is gone. Because we made it larger than life. And then Chennai Express was written in 2008 actually.
Okay.
And the script was with us.
So did you write that keeping someone in mind?
Yeah. He was a young guy.
Right.
Like young hero would have done the film. Okay. Then we tweaked it later on.
Right.
Made the guy a 40-year-old. You are not looked right for the audience. So I said, yeah, I don't want to do this film. I'll go and meet Shah Rukh and tell him. And I was all prepared. Shah Rukh said, okay, thank you so much. Dekho, maine samne se bulaya hai, toh bol. So he's like, I went and I told him that we have written the final draft, but it's not working for me. The simplicity and the beauty of the film has gone because it's become too commercial.
Right.
So he said one thing, and I told him that I have one more script, Chennai Express. If you want to hear that, otherwise we all started with Angoor and we are not doing that anymore. So he's like, Rohit, I want to do a film with you.
That's it. Doesn't matter what script.
Yeah. He said, I want to do a film with you. I want to do a Rohit Shetty film, whatever it is.
But personally, for you, Rohit, when you go from Ajay Devgan, who you've been so comfortable with, to a Shah Rukh, are equations any different?
Their working pattern is same.
Okay.
Very hard working. Like, I've never seen a day with Shah Rukh or for Ranveer or for Ajay that they come on set and they say that they're tired today. They come happily. They work with sincerity. You will see them sitting in one corner rehearsing their lines, and sometimes you see and you think, hey, this is Shah Rukh Khan. No, but the sincere, and as I said, that is one thing about Mr. Amitabh Bachchan or Shah Rukh or Ranveer or Ajay, that where they are today, is the sincerity towards work, not taking things for granted that I'm a star or I'm a hero or I've arrived now. It's never been like this with them. With Ajay, though, I've done so many films, but till today, if it's a long scene or it's a dramatic scene or emotional scene, you'll suddenly see him with one of my ADs sitting in one corner rehearsing, nervous. Same goes with Shah Rukh, he'll do around 27 to 30 rehearsals, he'll start sweating.
Right.
Plus, still he'll do it. Like, when he shot the whole climax with him, he was supposed to get operated.
But ladies and gentlemen, you're as good as an Arsenal, everyone. Roshan Sari Zameen जगमग हुआ सारा जहां उड़ने को तू आजाद है बंधन को ही अब है कहां